Hello friends, welcome to my channel 212.com. Today the topic that we are going to discuss is net force. In our previous class we have already studied about force, and now we know that force is a vector quantity. That means it has both direction as well as magnitude. Secondly, it is the interaction between two or more objects. So we will be using these two basic quantities and we will be finding the net force or the resultant force that is being applied to an object. Now, what exactly is a net force and why do we need to find it? So, you must have seen that in a tug of war, there are two people, like two sides, and both of these sides, they apply certain amount of force towards themselves, or I can say that each one pulls the rope towards itself and in the process applies a force on the rope. So, when the force is applied on the rope from the two direction, one side might apply a greater force as compared to the other person, like other side. So in that case, the rope is being pulled towards the team which applies greater force. So this greater force and how to calculate this greater force is what we'll study today. Like, how do you find it? How do you find the direction of the resultant force and how do you find the force? Because applied force can be in many ways. Right? So for that, we will do a basic simulation. So this simulation is being given by Fate Colorado, and we will be using this simulation to understand the net force that is being applied. Now let me just put the values first. So I'll tick this and I've crossed the sum. So I'll put one person here. Now I can see that the force applied by the blue person is 50 Newton towards the left. Now what I'll do is I'll put another person towards right, and that is also 50 Newton. Now since 50 Newton is applied towards left and 50 Newton is applied towards right, so I can say basically that both the forces, they get cancelled out, and in the process the resultant force that I get is zero. I hope this much is clear. Now what I'll do is I'll put another person. Now each person corresponds to 50 Newton of force. Now in this case, the left force is 50 Newton and the right force is that of the 100 Newton. So what I'll do is, now this is 50 and this is 100 Newton, right? So if what I'll do is I'll subtract the both the forces. Fine, because they are in the opposite direction. Had they been in the same direction, I would have added them, but since one is in this direction and the other one is in this direction, so I'll subtract them. Now if I subtract 150, I'll get 50 Newton. Firstly, you do not have to see which one you need to subtract. What you can do is, now there are two cases in which you can solve this. First is, you basically take the higher value and you subtract the lower value out of it, and the direction of the force would be in the direction in which there is the higher force. So one is that. Other is, you just randomly subtract it and the resultant will tell you the direction and the answer. For example, let me show it to you in both the cases. So 50 Newton minus 100 Newton will give me minus 50 Newton. Now minus means 50 Newton minus 100 Newton. So initially I need to take the direction in of the first one, like of the first magnitude that I have written. So that is 50 Newton. So 50 Newton minus 100 Newton in this direction will give me minus 50 Newton. Since minus is associated, so I'll just reverse that direction. Understood? Now I'll again explain it to you. So in this case, I have 50 Newton and I have 100 Newton. Initially what you do is, you take the higher value, 100 Newton, direction towards right, minus the other Newton, that is the lower Newton, which is 50 Newton, and the resultant would be 100 minus 50 will give me 50 Newton. The direction of the force would be in the direction where the larger force is applied. So here it is the 100 Newton, so my resultant answer would be 50 Newton towards right, as you can see. But had it been the other way around, had this person been here, so the resultant force would be 50 Newton and the more force is towards the left, so 50 Newton towards left. What about if there was force, if the force was applied only from one direction, that is from this. So this is two people, corresponds to 100 Newton towards left, so my resultant force is 100 Newton towards left. Now let me put this bigger person here. So he is 150 Newton. Now 150 Newton, that means towards right I have 150 Newton, towards left I have 100 Newton. So my resultant force would be 50 Newton towards right. Now let me just see if I'm right. Yes, See, the bucket is being pulled, the bucket of sweets is being pulled towards the right. Yes? Now let me again perform this activity. So I'll just quickly do it. I'll give you time to think and you can just think the answer in your mind. And when I tell the answer, you can just cross check. So I have placed this 150 Newton person here. I'll remove the sum of the forces. And I have placed this person also, which is 150. The resultant force would be, since in both the directions the same force is applied, so it would be 0 Newton and the direction would be nowhere. Right? Now next what I'll do is, I'll place one person here which is of 100 Newton. So my resultant force would be, bigger one is 150 towards left. So 150 Newton minus 100 Newton will give me 50 Newton and the direction would be towards the bigger one. So that is a left direction. Let's just see, 50 Newton towards left and let's perform the activity. So it's going toward left. I hope this is clear to you. If you want to open this simulation, you can log on to FET Colorado and easily use the simulation, or you can just check the video where we have used it. Now come back to our presentation. Now on the screen, you can see the simulation which we have just done. Now let's calculate a few of the resultant forces. Let me take my pen before we begin with the class. So on the left, I have 30 Newton. On the right, I have 60 Newton. I've just told you that the direction of force would be in the direction of the higher force. So 60 Newton is more than the 30 Newton. Magnitude 60 Newton is more. So it will be in this direction. And the resultant force would be 60 minus 30, that is 30 Newton. Let's do the another one. So 60 Newton towards left and 30 Newton towards right. Since they're in the opposite direction, so I will subtract them. Now more magnitude, 60 Newton has more magnitude. So the direction of force would be towards my left and the resultant magnitude would be the difference of the two. So that will give me 30 Newton again. Now in the third case, I have 60 Newton towards left and 60 Newton towards right. So both the forces are of equal magnitude. So they will just subtract each other. So my resultant Newton would be resultant magnitude would be 0 Newton. In the last case, I have 30 Newton towards left and 60 Newton towards right. So since both of them are in the same direction, so I will be adding those forces. That means that the resultant force would be 30 plus 60, which will give me 90 Newton, and the direction of the force would be towards the left. Since you know both the forces are applied towards left. I hope this part is clear to you. Now, if the forces cancel each other and I get the resultant force as 0 Newton, then the net force that is acting on the body would be a balance force. But if I get some value of the force and a direction in which it moves, then I would say that the force that is being applied is an unbalanced force. So balance force, the resultant force is 0 Newton. There will be no change in the state of the particle of the motion. The object will remain at rest. There will be no change in shape, size or the state. That is, if the object is at rest, it will stay at rest. If it is in motion, then it will remain in motion. I hope this part is clear to you. Let's quickly see what we have done. So the resultant force here would be 30 Newton. This one is 30 Newton towards left. This one is 90 Newton towards left and this is 0 Newton. So case which are marked by green are the unbalanced forces and the case marked by red is my balanced force. I hope this part is clear to you. Let's quickly summarize what we have just done. So resultant forces are of two types. They are the balanced forces and the unbalanced forces. Now balanced forces are the one in which the resultant force is 0 Newton. And the unbalanced force are the forces in which there is some magnitude and the direction of the resultant force is there. For the balanced force, there is no change in the motion. It's opposite in direction. See, for opposite, it can either be one direction is this one or another is this one. So the signs, the motion, the force, direction of the force should be in different directions. That's a key point. And they're equal in size. Equal in size means that they are equal in magnitude. For example, here I have 60 Newton and 60 Newton acting on the box. Now for the unbalanced forces, it occurs when one force is greater than the other. So the direction of the force will be in the direction in which the greater force is acting and you need to subtract those. Second, it shows the effect of force on the object. Now we will be studying about the effect of forces. It causes change in shape, size and the state of rest or motion of an object. And for the unbalanced forces, it can be in the same direction or opposite in direction. I hope this is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please do not forget to write in the comment section. So I hope this topic is clear to you. Please do not forget to subscribe and like this video and do not miss any science and maths video that we are uploading. Visit our website www.tutelf.com for more educational videos or to try online tests, which let me tell you are graded instantly related to the topic, and to get best quality study material and much more, please do visit our site. So wait for the next video. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye bye.